Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Salvation Army St. John's Citadel Worship at Home. We are so glad that you have joined us this morning. I hope you're doing well in the midst of this pandemic as the days and weeks go on, that you are experiencing the amazing presence of God with you in these days. It really does make all of the difference. Revelation 21 and verse 3 says this about his presence. Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. Before Josh comes and leads us in worship this morning, I would like to share a prayer with you as we commence our service today. Our Father and our God, we thank you. Thank you for your amazing presence with us. It is not only a future hope, it is a current reality that we can experience every single day of our lives. We thank you, Father, for the comfort and the peace that comes with knowing your presence with us, that is with us in spite of circumstances, and we can experience your blessing upon our lives by knowing you and being in relationship with you, providing all that we need in these uncertain days. And so, Father, today I pray for each person that has tuned into our service, that as we share these moments together online, we would pray that by your Holy Spirit's presence, you will be with each of them. You will bless them, minister to their need today, and may they experience you in such an amazing way, knowing your presence with them and all that brings to their lives. And so, Father, we give you grateful praise for the opportunity of worshiping you in spirit and in truth. Bless us as we share these moments together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. May you be blessed as you share with us today. God bless you, Josh.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the St. John's Citadel worship this morning. We want to welcome you all here, regardless of where you are this morning. We know you can be at home, at the cabin, with your friends, family, with your double bubble or single bubble, wherever you stand with the new legislations. But we want to join together this morning in praise and worship, and we're going to sing a few songs with you. So we hope you can join us this morning.
As we gather, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name. Knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. We'll be blessed because we came. As we gather, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name. Knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. We'll be blessed because we came. Thank you. winds rise and thunders roar. I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God.
We know that this morning it's some difficult times. You know, we're all separated, but His presence is here regardless of where we worship. So, you know, we can worship as a small family unit, we can worship in the four walls of a church, but that doesn't change who we are, that doesn't change the fact that we are His church. And His presence reassures us. He hides us underneath His wing and protects us from these hardships. He's giving us the strength to go through this, so we need to rely on Him in these times. So let's just sing that proclamation this morning.
When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. Be still and know you are God. I'm in His hands. I'm in His hands. Whatever the future holds, I'm in His hands. The days I cannot see have all been planned.
Today's scripture is taken from Luke 24, verses 36 to 49. And if we try and put it into a little bit of context, the disciples just watched Jesus being taken away and crucified, and now they find themselves alone and possibly isolated, possibly very similar to how some of us might feel today. But the Lord appears to them and provides them with some reassurance. And may we find that same reassurance today. Luke says, while they were still talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and frightened, thinking they saw a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you troubled, and why do doubts rise in your minds? Look at my hands and my feet. It is I myself. Touch me and see. A ghost does not have flesh and bones, as I see I have." When he said this, he showed them his hands and feet. And while they still did not believe it because of joy and amazement, he asked them, "Do you have anything to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. He said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms." Then he opened their minds so that they could understand the scriptures. He told them, "This is what is written. The Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance and forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. I am going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." I just leave this final thought with you, that fear does not have to be the last word or to be the loudest voice within us, for it is God's love that always drives it away. May the Lord add a blessing to his word and to us.
Good morning. Thank you, Samantha, for that beautiful vocal selection this morning. In this post-Easter season, we've been focusing on encounters with Jesus following his resurrection in a sermon series entitled A Powerful Presence. We want to highlight the difference his presence can make within our lives because we believe that we serve a real God for real life. 2 weeks ago, our divisional leader shared with us Thomas's experience, and we witnessed a powerful presence that dispels doubt. And last week, Ern shared with us the experience of the two on the road to Emmaus, and we saw a powerful presence that draws near. This morning, we see in our scripture reading, even as the two are sharing their Emmaus road experience with the others, that Jesus shows up at exactly the right time, and his presence brings reassurance to his fearful band of followers. Ever had an experience where the bottom seems to have fallen out? I guess we can certainly relate to that feeling in recent days, as we've been trying to navigate this new normal. Everything about how we normally conducted our lives has changed drastically, and in some ways, it has even caught us by surprise. Where do you turn to when everything that you have placed your hopes upon comes crashing down? We rest in the assurance of Jesus, for he is the God who draws near and reassures us that all is well. He is God in control. There is cause for hope. We've all had those moments in our lives when we have needed some form of reassurance. You know, those times in life that where it seemed so uncertain, the future looked dim, but yet when we have experienced some reassurance through perhaps God's word, through a song, through a friend's encouraging phone call, life seemed to be a little bit more bearable afterwards, did it not? Well, here in Luke chapter 24, we see the disciples feeling as if the bottom had just fallen out of their entire world. They felt alone, lost, bewildered. They found themselves longing for something to happen that would give them a renewed sense of assurance and hope. They were looking for the kind of hope that is found in a resurrected Savior, the hope that is found in sins forgiven, the hope that is found in the promise of eternal life. This is why the words of that old church hymn says this, "For my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name." Max Lucado of this passage writes, "The Church of Jesus Christ began with a group of frightened men in a second floor room in Jerusalem. Though they had marched with him for 3 years, their most courageous act now was to get up and to lock the door. It was an hour of self-examination. All of their efforts had seemed so futile. When the Roman soldiers took Jesus, Jesus' followers took off. With the very wine of the covenant on their breath and the bread of sacrifice in their bellies, they simply fell away. All the boasts of bravado and declarations of devotions lay broken and shattered at the gate of Gethsemane's garden. We don't know where the disciples went when they fled the garden, but we do know that they took the memory of a man who called himself no less than God in the flesh. And they couldn't get him out of their minds. And as a result, they came back to the church of our Lord. And this began with a group of frightened men in an upper room. Here we see confused, fearful ambassadors behind closed doors. What will it take for them to unlock those doors? What will it take for them to ignite their fire within their hearts? What will it take to restore their feelings of passion? Well, the answer is found in the very words of Jesus Christ that day to them and to us today. "Peace be with you." The stone of the tomb could not hold him, and the walls even of that very room could not keep him out. One can only imagine the feelings of doubt and insecurity that probably went through the minds of the disciples just prior to the appearance of Christ. His reappearing to them in this way was most likely the furthest thing from their mind. But yet, here he was, in physical form, confronting them with those words which they longed to hear, as we do as well. those familiar words of Jesus in our day, in our times today, peace, be still. John 16 and 33 in God's word says this, I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, Jesus says, for I have overcome the world. I was reminded this week once again of the scene in Scripture as noted in Mark 4, 38 to 39. And in this account, it is where the disciples and Jesus are out in the boat being tossed about by the winds and the waves. For it says in Scripture, Jesus was in the stern of the boat, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples awoke him and said to him, Teacher, don't you even care if we drown? So he got up, rebuked the wind, and he said to the waves, Peace, be still. Then the wind died down, and it was completely, completely calm. They were terrified, and Scripture says, and they asked each other this question, Who is this, that even the wind and the waves obey him? If Christ can calm the winds and the waves out on a lake, then how much more could he not do within our hearts and our lives if we were to simply invite him to come and to be a part of our everyday living, our everyday journey, our everyday experience? The words of that chorus sums up what the peace of Christ can do, not only in our world, but in our hearts and our lives today. For it says this, For there is peace in the midst of the storms of my life. There's an anchor. There's a rock to build my faith upon. You see, we are living in a different time, in a different world today. We've all had those moments and those times when the challenges of life has brought us troubles and heartache. There have been those times, perhaps even when fear and unrest has brought about troubles and confusion. But yet this morning, Jesus Christ invites us to come to him and to experience a true sense of peace in the midst of what we are going through today. Isaiah 43 verses 2 and 3 says, When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk even through the fire, you will not be burned, for the flames will not set you ablaze. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. It's true that we can't always see what God is doing when we are facing or going through troubling times, but we can rest assured in knowing that He is in control, even when things seem to be out of control. Jesus reminds his disciples in this passage that though it looked as if all was lost, God's plan was still on track. Isaiah 55 and 9 says this, For my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. We may not be able to control what is happening around us. We can't control the weather. We can't control the economy, but we can rest assured in the knowledge of knowing that Jesus Christ, through his presence, is with us, providing all that we need. Today, Christ desires nothing more than to place within you his reassuring presence so that the crisis that we are facing today won't paralyze us, so that sadness that is experienced in this world won't overwhelm us, so that fear won't intimidate us. This is why we sing, Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face, for surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. In a moment, Josh is going to come and he's going to sing for us that chorus. But before he does, I would kindly ask that during this coming week, if you would, find a few moments to read once again Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 49, and contemplate that scene within your heart and your mind that is noted in this passage. Then take some time and allow Jesus Christ to come into your upper room and to stand before you. Run your fingers over his feet, place your hand in his pierced side, and look into his eyes. Those very same eyes that melted the gates of hell and sent Satan running. Look at them as they look at you, and I assure you, your life will never be the same. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. May God richly bless you as Josh sings for us today.
I see glory on his face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Thank you, Josh, for that beautiful reminder that the presence of Jesus Christ is always with us. Thank you, Samantha, for your beautiful vocal selection this morning. And thank you each and every one for joining us online. Our prayer for you this week is that you will truly sense and know the reassuring presence of Jesus Christ, that you will know that he is always with you throughout each and every day. I want to share with you a benediction from Scripture itself, and it says this: Now all glory to God, who is able to keep you from falling, and he will bring you with great joy into his glorious presence without fault. All glory to him who alone is God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. All glory, majesty, power, and authority are his before all time, and in the present, and beyond all the time. May God richly bless you, each one.